being an artist yourself, what is the transformative power of creation? What is it that a work of art can do to people to change them?
Well, everybody has their own answer to that. I mean, really, it's an unanswerable question, really. It's like saying, you know, how does the power of prayer transform you? You know, it is a truth. It is the truth. You feel filled with love. Mm-hmm. You know, I can say, my brother died. I was heartbroken that my brother died at a young age, and my husband died. I had experienced a lot of death when I was in my 40s. And one day I was walking down the street, and all of a sudden I felt a warmth flow through my body, and I felt so happy. And I knew it was my brother, because that was who my brother was. He was just a happy, joyful, kind person, which I'm not always, not like him. And I knew it wasn't me, it was him, it was truth. People feel entered by God that way. You look at a Jackson Pollock and feel entered in that way, you know, or you see a little child running across a field and feel that way. I can't really answer that for anyone else. All I can say, it's an indisputable truth that doesn't need to be broken down, philosophized, or critiqued. It's just a truth, like nature, like a blade of grass. It just is.
Mm-hmm. Antonio. Well, at least here, Western Europe is very much a secular world. Why do you think that religion, because we are dealing here with a monk, why do you think that religion still can provide a kind of moral compass to deal with, quote unquote, our original sin?
Well, considering what we just saw, I was really kept by the last image, considering what happened before. So the image of the Trinity, which is powerful. And I was wondering why so powerful. They are just three angels, so nothing more. Of course, the colors, which are very vivid, red, blue, gold. But I think that the reason, the real reason why I'm really taken by that image is that the perspective is inverted. So all is far inside of the picture is big, and what is close is small, which is exactly the opposite of the Renaissance perspective, what we are used, our way of seeing things. So that icon change, which is deeply rooted in religion, has the power to change our way of seeing things. And this is the power of religion. So seeing things from the point of view of a love who really embraced the world, because that image is completely inclusive. So since what is far away is big and what is close is small, means that you are included. You are included. So it's as if you see from a window in an inverted perspective. So you are embraced by the picture. You are included inside. So your loneliness is included. This is why I think it's a masterpiece, because your sufferance, your loneliness, all the evil things we experience every day are included in that picture. And I think that the Andrei Rublev feel need to paint that icon this way. So I feel the need. And this is what really struck me in a work of art. If I feel the need of the artist to paint that way or to write that way. So I feel the humanity included. So religion comes from the Latin religo, which means put together. Bind together different things. I mean, religion is able to embrace the human suffering, the human disquiet, the human restlessness, as we said before, in a vision of love.